because some people out there will hang themselves no matter what at the end of the day. You know, his ego, his attitude, you know, it is what it is.
Thank you, Womb Cowboy.
You know, what are you getting?
I'm getting comments.
For what?
About my Freddy skills.
Oh, for you. Oh, I thought it was something else. I thought it was your you guys want to ask him some questions, you know, send them our way.
Fuck you. CK7, legit Freddy. I see. I don't want to hear that shit from other people, man. I'm getting hit up all over the place for my comments. Jesus fucking Christ. Who the fuck hit me up now?
All right, let me make another call.
Okay, go ahead. Make another call. Yeah, in the meantime, MT Dave, learn some fucking goddamn combos, right? I'm getting sick of that shit, bro. Freddy's got an inside game. He's got 50-50 mix-ups, man. You got to learn that shit. Full screen franchise, don't cut it no more.
Yo.
Yeah, we're you know what? The question about the whole PL thing leaving EMP, to be honest, I don't even know why. We're going to see if Triforce will shed a little light on that. I know he doesn't want to get too deep into that, but I know he wants to shed some light on that. So we're trying to get him on the show. All right, guys, I'll do a poll for you guys. Who's got the best Freddy? Type 1 for me, type 2 for M2 Dave. Let's see the chat go flood up over here. Three was not an option. All
right, so you know what? Hit me up.
Neither is nine.
All right.
Yo, Pig, me and you got to play a little more, man. I got to get that Melina match.
All right, I just spoke to Chris G and Beefutecki. They're stuck in traffic between 8 on the break and Brooklyn. They're going to be delayed about an hour. I got Mr. Triforce on here right now. I'm going to message him and see.
Is he online finally?
Yeah.
Okay. Can't hear you. Okay, there you go.
Yeah, James, what's up?
What's up, guy? What's going
what's
on? Guys, I got the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Triforce, Isaiah. What's been going on with you lately? It's been kind of a little quiet with a little drama here and there. You know, I know you're working hard on the VXG events. What else do you got going on these days?
Well, right now we're closing up the season. As you already know, the all-time winning Mortal Kombat champion Ryo is pretty much, you know, getting ready for MLG Dallas. I got some stuff that I got to do with Nintendo, and pretty much that's about it. Cause right after Dallas is that's Christmas time, and that's when I'm gonna do my thing with Nintendo. And we're not really gonna start up anything until late January, early February. So that right now, that's I'm doing this big project, getting these two movies done. And that's pretty much it.
Obviously, you know, everybody said, and I'm not gonna hit too hard on it because I don't know if you can really talk about it much. But you know, it's been floating around that Mr. Perfect Legend is leaving the Empire.
No, that's not true. Perfect Legend isn't leaving the Empire. Perfect Legend has already left the Empire. He walked away from his contractual obligations. He felt that for whatever reason, that Empire KD wasn't a fit for him. So he left, and he's now seeking options for himself, wherever those options may be. And
In-N-Out Burger has options. Oh, wait, did I say that? My bad. Arby's.
You know, he has a title, so he has two titles. Actually, three, four, actually, if you count in World Cyber Games. But
actually, five, because biggest emo on the planet is a title that I've given him.
Oh, man, James, you be going in.
And you know, and his Siamese twin, Claude Von Stroke, who's his mouthpiece, could vouch for him winning the emo champion of the year plus Evo champion. So it wasn't just one thing he won; he won Evo and emo at the same time. I'm not gonna zap him too hard, but I don't know what he's thinking. I mean, I don't know, you know. You know, I've said to him over the last year that his attitude is his own worst enemy. I hope, you know, I don't know, maybe DOA's hooking him up with something, or somebody's hooking him up with something. But you know, GGA, Perfect Legend, maybe. I have no idea. I know he was supposed to be going out to Chicago to hang out with the GGA guys this weekend, or today, should I say. And it's not James. When PL wins and gets big, he is all of a sudden no more. When he needs to come back, well, here's Red Rum AM with saying, it is not just James. When PL wins and gets big, he is all of a sudden no more EMP. When he needs some back, it is like, let me look at EMP again. Now let's look at EMP. So, you know, with that said, and now, other people have said this. I've seen some tweets floating out there that, you know, people were kind of like, yeah, okay, you know, he's leaving until he comes back. Is this a revolving door, or is this a one-way door this time around?
No. The thing is, let's not try to make this about Perfect Legend, because you know, in terms of the whole revolving door, this is in 2011, when I suspended the fighting game division, we were having a fallout with all of the players. A lot of, because of the King of Chinatown movie, a lot of the perception was, you know, since Justin left Empire Arcadia, the Empire is going to fall. And with that being said, a lot of players started, it's like a sinking ship. They wanted to see what options they could go to that was, you know, for greener pastures. And they jumped ship. Those in the Empire that didn't have a ship to jump to pretty much stayed because, you know, either... I don't know why they stayed. But my job was to try to restructure the whole organization so that it could give them some type of security or assurance that the organization is not going to sink because we lost one player. So I had to suspend the division. When I suspended the division, I restarted up the organization. I suspended in August of 2011 all the way to January 2012. When I restarted the organization, I told everyone, listen, now is the time to make your decision whether or not you want to stay with the organization. Because when I suspended everyone, I released everybody from their contractual obligations, all contracts that were signed at the time, null and void. And I just told everyone that, listen, you don't have to stay, you can go. And I told them, if you want to get a whack at this one more time, we can. If not, I was just going to close up the fighting game division of the Empire. We've done a lot in the fighting game scene from 2002 all the way to 2011, middle year of 2011. And we didn't need to win another EVO championship. That's the reality. That's the truth about it. We don't need to win any more fighting games. People think we need to win. And no, we don't. I'm not going to constantly keep proving to people year after year that this organization can win in a fighting game. That's stupid. That means the organization is a slave. It's a slave to the people's demands and expectations. So that means the minute we lose, we're dead. No, I'm going to look to put this organization in a different light. The players agreed and said, okay, they want to give it another twirl, one more twirl, blah, blah, blah. So I said, all right, let's give it a shot. You know, we won Power Up. We placed well at, what's the name of this thing? the Chicago tournament. We placed top three in like four of the games. Perfect Legend won Evo for Empire. We went out to VXG. Cypher Kelly won a Marvel International tournament. We came back. We won two chips at Summer Jam. And then Rio wins at MLG. When you look at this overall, this is just for us in the fighting game division. Not to mention we get the Guinness World Record for the most winning teams. We have done more in this 1 year than we've done in any year of the Empire previously in terms of the accolades. We have a Guinness World Championship, a Fighting Game World Championship, an International World Championship, and we have like three major championships in the community. One more, and then we have MLG. Oops, I almost forgot. And so we have an Esports League Championship. What more do people want? And it's just like, you know, I just told people, listen, if you want to walk, you can walk. Championship players come a dime a dozen. And it sounds messed up, but that's the truth about it. Championship players come a dime a dozen. You know, you had Perfect Legend, right? You had Justin, you had Yipes, you had Safford, you had Issei. You have Black Mamba. There's so many different players. But once they go, that's it. I'm done. We will simply look for another champion.
Well, you got the true, you know, at the end of the day. And, you know, I don't care. I'm going to say it this way. Yes, I see Claude being the mouthpiece for PL because PL is too much of a bitch to come on my show. And that's real talk, like you would say. He's afraid to come on my show because he knows I put him in his place. I'm not going to have nobody talk down to anybody else, especially me. With that said, the only well-rounded true champion there is in this community is Rio. Rio is officially, in my opinion, the most winningest, most accomplished Mortal Kombat player.
But wait. Before, the reason why there's no need to say that is because when Carl was Empire, we mentioned that. I said, before he even won his second championship, I said, listen, nothing, no offense to Carl being the champion, but Perfect Legend is the Evo world champion. When he won his second championship, I said he's a two-time world champion. But I've expressed this on your show numerous times. Rio is the Mortal Kombat all-time champion. This is no disrespect to Perfect Legend. It is just a fact to point out. The man has been winning championships dating back to MK2. This game is just a game Carl has stumbled into, and he's very proficient at it. And he has won the last two evolutions, making him the two-time undisputed world champion for Mortal Kombat 9. So no one can take that away from Perfect Legend. That's what it is.
No, I won't, you know, and like I said, I don't discredit him for winning the Evos. Now, I could always throw out he played on one player side the whole time, that's why he won. But I won't even go there with that, because that's just stupid. But I mean, I see Claude, yeah, you can, and once again, I'm not going to do something that other people have done to me in the past and say who you're friends with, well, then you can't talk to me. But when you're friends with somebody, you're blind as a bat. If you don't see him as an arrogant son of a bitch, then you are absolutely blind. I watched him put down players. I watched him walk away from players after losing to them, telling them their ass.
Well, okay, look, all right. I'm not going to sit here and then play politics and say, okay, I'm not going to call Perfect Legend arrogant. The issue here is that I do not want to make it sound like I'm salty because he left and I'm bashing him. We all know what Perfect Legend is. I'm going to leave it at that. I've expressed to him what I think about him and his personality versus his persona. And everyone in the community knows what it is. So I'm not here to bash him. That I don't want that to be taken away from me being on a show. Oh, Carl left and Triforce One went on MK James' show to trash him. That is not it. Honestly speaking, he's already expressed himself to me in that manner. He told me directly he did not join this organization to be on teams or help develop anybody else or a brand. He joined this organization to help himself and develop his name. That's what he told me.
Okay.
Period. So everyone can draw their own conclusions from that. And we'll just leave it at that. Apparently, this organization, no, it's not even apparently, this organization does not work for him. And if that's how he views the organization, then this is not the right organization for him. And the best thing for him to do was leave and go be his own empire. The Empire Kitty does not have room for players with that mentality. That's just what it is. So we're going to leave it alone. I spoke to the sponsors to see if him leaving would jeopardize any of the current agreements that we have with them, and we are renegotiating our original deals and how to make up for him leaving, and we were able to secure that. So as long as that didn't jeopardize me, I'm like, oh, okay, perfect. It doesn't jeopardize me. No problem. Go about your business, whatever the case may be. My only concern was that when I make these deals, these players who come into the organization say they want to, One second. Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry about that. Okay, so I just was letting someone know that I'm on a show and I can't talk right now.
Nobody will be choking me out, Baruch Goldstein, especially PL. I mean, unless he plans on rolling over my throat with his roller skates, he ain't got a chance in hell. I'm not, and once again, I don't take away from him as a player. He's a great player.
He's a great player.
He's a great player.
He's a great player.
He's a great player.
Yeah. What if you turn your speakers off?
Somebody has their speaker on. Thank you. All right. So, going back to the situation regarding him, like, he's gonna go do what he's gonna do. A lot of players want to.
He's gonna go do what he's gonna do.
Someone turn off your speaker.
Natus, turn your speakers off.
Turn off your speaker.
Natus, turn your speakers off.
Turn off your speaker.
There you go. There you go. I just take him off the call. Voila. And I see people in the chat. Why is everybody dick riding him? You know why? Because, in my opinion, and it's my opinion, he's not a positive for this community. And that's the truth. And everybody can say whatever they want, and we could say this is my opinion. Look at every community, that every game he partakes in. I'm not the only, for those people that say, oh, no, Jimmy, I'm salty, I'm bitter. About what? Because I'm not winning? I don't give a shit. I don't come to the tournaments to win. If I did, I'm doing a really shitty job. I come to have fun, hang out, and watch the community grow. But, PL complaining about all bullshit, this guy sucks, this one, somebody's stealing my limelight. Who are you? You're no more important than Pig the Hut. You're no more important than CD Jr., Rio. You're no more important than freaking Claude Von Stroke. You're just another piece of this community. I don't care if you're an online player, an offline player, the MLG, the Evo, the goddamn Universal Champ. When the community has egos and attitudes that are going out there, that is reflected what people perceive your community as. Because you're putting that person at the forefront of being the representative of this community. And we went into the whole thing with the freaking cantaloupes and all that shit. And it goes back to that. No one person, not me, not my show, not 9.95, not Shock, not Jugs, not PL, nobody is the spokesman for this community. That's why it's called a community. And if we can't police ourselves, and I've said to PL on many occasions, drop the ego. Drop the ego. I know, I sound salty as fuck. Why are you jealous of his accomplishments? Well, let's see. How about this for an accomplishment since I'm so jealous? Is there anybody in this community, and I repeat this, anybody that has won for 4 or 5 years straight, nonstop? No. So until you can say that, stop saying that I'm jealous. You know, and not to mention, drop your caps. You know, here we go. I got one more person. He won't come into my show because, you know, in a nutshell, he don't like me. And you know what? I don't like him either. You know, oh, well, paper legend. It was a joke. Get over it. You know. What do we got? What do we got here? All right. Limbo Dog. James, shut the fuck up and make your wife strip on the stream live. Well, you know, I would do that, but first your mom's got to lick my nuts. When your mom's done licking my nuts, then I'll have my wife come out and strip for you. Oh, and your little sister's got to take it in the coolie also. Oh, by the way, next time you walk away, Natus, don't leave your speaker on.
No, I know what happened. Since I got the camera now, the camera mic kicked on when I took off the headset.
Oh, okay.
So like I said, because we're kind of getting this, went from what are we going to do to the situation with Perfect Legend. Perfect Legend is going to go and do what Perfect Legend is going to do. The reality is that, as I told you before, we had conversations in private when I said, remember when I was telling you, I was like, I don't think Rio is getting his real, you know, the real attention and push he deserves. I'm actually, a lot of the players are not getting their real attention and push that they deserve. And not for nothing, but, you know, Junior wasn't being properly marketed in VVV. Remember we had that conversation?
Yes.
And I expressed that to both. It was me, Carl, CD Junior, Detroit Bolin, and Rio all in the same room. This was MLG... Yeah, this was Anaheim. Yeah, it was Anaheim. It was after the whole Ohio thing. And I told them that, you know, that VVV wasn't really doing anything to help develop them as players so that they can stand alone. And and I explained to them why. And it's funny how I explained to them why, and then yet I do the very same thing why the other companies don't do it. These companies don't like developing players and helping them to blow up to certain levels because they're afraid that it's the liability that can happen. Helping a player to develop when they get to a certain standard that they feel they no longer need the organization, and then they walk away from the organization, leaving the organization in a very, you know, peculiar situation where they're going to have to now, they were building everything to work through this one particular, you know, construct, but then they lost it. So now how do they get the job done without it? It's much like the whole Justin Wong thing. You know, everyone says Triforce is a leech. He's leeching off of Justin Wong to make Empire Arcadia. That's like saying Phil Jackson is a leech for leeching off of Michael Jordan. That doesn't make any sense. Michael Jordan is a part of a team. He's a coach. His job is to utilize Michael Jordan's talents for the team to win. So how is he using him? So in the very same right, I'm doing that with Justin Wong. But then because remember we was talking about unions and how there's no unions and stuff like that?
Yep.
There are no unions. There are no athletic sports commission. There's no nothing. So players can walk away. You could take them to court, but what are you going to sue the player for? Especially when most of these players, they're broke and they don't have a job. So when people sit there and like, oh, you got these fake contracts and you can't, they don't know what they're talking about because the law of the land is if you have a binding agreement with an individual and the binding agreement states the nature of their literature it brings an understanding where both parties agree to a specific thing, and then one party does his part or her part and the other party does not, the person that does not is held liable in court. How that turns out, how they're going to make up for that is what the courts decide. But it takes money to take people to court for that. Then you have to look at the amount of money you're spending to take someone to court versus how much you're going to get. And when you look at it, it's not worth it.
This is why you've never seen a gamer ever taken to court for their contract, because the entity that's managing the player won't really gain anything from it. But then at the same time, the player can't get anything from the managing entity when they walk away from the contract. For instance, let's say, I'm just going to throw this out there. We sign a deal with SteelSeries, Ryo's Mortal Kombat feat, Perfect Legends Mortal Kombat feat earlier this year, us getting the Guinness World Championship, Cypher winning the International Championship, Black Mamba winning, Soul Calibur, what's the name of this thing, Summer Jam, and then Denkai winning Virtual Fighter at Summer Jam, and then, you know, UFGT, and then Cypher winning Power Up. All these wins, they say, we want to do a deal with you guys. $125,000 for some joystick that we want to put out to go up against the competition out there. And the money comes to the organization. The player who walked away from the organization couldn't take us to court because they abandoned their contractual obligations. So any money coming in, even if we use their name at the time to get said contract, we still keep the profit. So that's why a lot of players just jump ship from team to team. No one's going to gain, and, well, someone can lose, but no one's really going to gain. So that's why I really didn't take Justin to court, because I'm not going to gain anything from it unless I sue EG. You see what I'm saying? But then, like EG said, I'm not going to be able to win because I don't have their money to fight them in court, which they're right. I don't have the money to fight them in court. So it's like when all of this is said and done, the companies are not going to develop the players. And then when the players are not getting developed and they're not getting the true media attention that they deserve and that they need, they don't go anywhere until a scene overlaps and builds up over them and makes so much money off of them. Then they try to come and say, hey, can I get my money's worth and blah, 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 blah. Let me show you something for a second. This is a site. Esports earnings. Fatality has earned $454,000 in competitive gaming. $454,000 in his lifetime winning. I'm going to show you a joke. Fatality has earned more marketing himself and selling brand Fatality in the millions over what he made playing video games. So when people who sit there with this dream, hey, I want to be a competitive gamer, I want to go out there and I want to win all this money. What money? You're winning peanuts versus the marketing value of the persona you can sell. And that's what Empire Arcadia, that's the service Empire Arcadia does for its gamers.
Let me just interject for a second, because, you know, this then on blast or whatever the hell shit. Yeah, I keep seeing your thing. I'm letting Triforce speak to not be rude. Nobody cares about me, and that's fine. But you know what?
Who's talking to you?
This the on blast. He's some troll.
Yeah, please let me destroy him.
Hold on. First of all, you want to know what my obsession with PL is? I'm always obsessed with pieces of shit. How's that? All right. Little motherfuckers, insignificant motherfuckers that put themselves on pedestals. How did he? Oh, he's the DOH. Oh, wait, no, he's not. That's Master. I'm sorry. He won two Evos. Who gives a fuck?
Well, all right.
I don't care. Wait. I don't care that he won Evos. It's irrelevant. It's two tournaments in fucking a year and a half that he won. Right. Didn't he come in like second to last at one of the CEOs? You know, does that make him a little garbage? No, my point is it's how he talks to me, and B, how he talks about other people. All of you on the stream, whether it be Pig or Max, yeah, Maxter was trash. Well, obviously Trash whooped the piss and shit out of him at the last MLG. You know, so it's like, it's the shit talking that I don't like. And yes, I will get my knees dirty going into the shit talking gutter too. I don't care. But with that said, you know, I don't.
But the thing, I don't mean to cut you off, James. See, here's the thing. The people who interact with Carl on a personal level knows the real version of him versus the commercial perception put out there. Tom Brady and my job was to clean up his image and his reputation. That was our job. I believe we did a very good job in doing that. The reason why this entire thing, even speaking about him, is irrelevant is because we know who he is, how he is, and what he's going to do. There is no need for us to discuss this. He's going to do what he's going to do, and we, myself and Brady, will not be there. And what's going to happen to him, or how I should best say this, what he deserves is coming. So we should just leave it at that.
I'm going to, because you know what? I want to watch, because I'll tell you this right now. If anybody, and this includes, and I'm going to put this out right now, if NRS comes up to me tomorrow and says, who should test the game, I could tell you who's not going to be on that list.
But
it's not because of his attitude as far as a person. It's because of his attitude as a player. I make a game. You don't dictate to me. You're hired to do a job, okay? Mm. And do you not think people in NRS who he's interacted with have that, who the fuck do you think you are, dictating what Kung Lao should be? You know, and that's the point. It's the simple fact that rather than talk to people eye to eye, he likes to look down on people. And that's the part of it that I don't like. You're no better than me. I don't care. If he wins the next 65 EVOs, I could kick the shit out of him from New York to Ohio and back 100,000 times. And I'll give him a baseball bat as a weapon.
My main thing is I hope during the time that me and Brady took to teach him the ropes about the industry that we've suppressed that side of him that people, well, actually some people know, because at Anaheim when Denzel beat him, we all gathered outside. It was like 20 to 30 of us, Mortal Kombat, and some person walked up to him and said, hey man, yo, congratulations. And he was like, man, don't fucking congratulate me. Everybody fucking here sucks. Detroit Bowling was standing right next to him. CD Jr. was standing out there. Pickett the Hutt, Denzel's crew. In fact, everybody who played in the 20 was there, and he just called them, they all suck. Which me and Brady just stared at him, and we're like, in our head, we're like, please shut the fuck up. Because like this makes you look like a bad loser. But the thing is, we hope that during the time, because as a developer, at the end of the day, you want the best for the player, because they help the scene overall. And the way it comes out is like, okay, if he does good, it reflects on the organization, because it says, you know, that guy started from Empire. So whatever he does good is a great reflection on us. But, you know, if he doesn't, it's not necessarily a bad reflection on us either, because he left the organization, but it's only going to hurt the player. And everyone who's watching and listening needs to understand that you egotistical people who think winning means everything, winning doesn't mean anything. You guys have to come to realize this. Some of the most prominent figures in the entire gaming scene do not win anything, but they make more money than most of the people that do. And there is a reason for it. Champions are born a dime a dozen. Every time a new game enters a competitive circuit, a new champion is born. And they come in different sizes, flavors, colors, all types of stuff each month. So what is the value of something that's constant? That's a question. Hello? Wait a minute.
Yeah, it's on. It's on.
Oh, wow. I think my mic had went out, so I didn't know. I didn't hear.
No,
you.
We heard you.
Oh, what is the value of something constant?
It depends. I mean, if it's a constant in a positive way, it's invaluable. If it's a negative way, it has a negative value on it. So, I mean,
let me ask you a question. Okay, there's 7 trillion. There's 7 billion people on the planet. What's the value of 100 mega trillion dollars.
Basically what you said, 100 mega trillion dollars if it was a denomination.
Actually, it's equal to zero.
Why?
Because it's 100. There's enough money where everyone can get the money twice on the planet. So who cares? Everyone has it. If everyone has it, it has no value. If every one of us on the planet had the same wives, what makes our wives special and valuable?
Well, which one takes it in the coolie? It's a value on that. Let me hold on, because I got one more person. I got OBS K Frog, who took second place this past weekend up in Canada. I know he wanted to chime in on this, so before I leave him sitting there all silent, what's up there, Mr. K Frog?
What's going on there, Jimmy? I, as usual, I have a couple things to say. Napalm, you're going to enjoy this thoroughly.
Oh, shit.
You know, there's a lot of things that bother me in this life. The main one is shit talkers that don't put their money where their mouth is. And the first person on my list here, and I'm sorry, Triforce, I know that you like this guy and everything, Mr. Tom Brady. A lot of you guys, I don't know if you saw him at the beginning of the Mortal Kombat scene when MK9 came out. And you know what? The Not on Blast show, shut the fuck up, all right? How about that? Take your goddamn caps lock off and stop talking a bunch of shit about shit that you don't understand. Calling James MK out for being a pussy and caring about winning at Mortal Kombat. Are you fucking retarded? Like, seriously. He doesn't give a shit. He's out there to party and meet people. And you're sitting here trying to play off egos and why are you attacking PL? I swear to God, just shut the fuck up. You fucking suck. You're horrible. You should just delete your account. Nobody cares what the fuck you're saying. You're shut up. Juggs, by the way, Juggs, why have mods if we're not going to fucking mod? Because we don't like to silence people. And if this fucker wants to just run his mouth, what's going to happen is the whole chat's just going to think he's retarded anyway, so it doesn't matter. Now, I'm not done with Tom Brady yet. Tom Brady, I challenge you to a first to 10, Ermac on Sub-Zero. I will destroy you. Online, offline, it doesn't matter. You talk so much shit back in the day, I don't see you placing top now, buddy. You're on the fucking commentary, so let's go. Let's go. First to 10. I will try to make it out to Dallas. Fuck the tournament, just to come out there and beat your ass down. Okay, that's Brady. I'm done with Brady. Now, Tim Static. I called you out. I called you out on Facebook. I called you out in front of everybody. And now, you're not on the show. You won't come on the show. You don't want to, I mean, what even happened to TYM, by the way? Does anyone know? Like Jesus, like it's been down for like weeks.
And this guy's supposed to be, domain.
This guy's supposed to be a community leader. And he won't even address legit concerns, and he won't even come and have a real conversation about stuff. He'd rather just be in the sidelines and, you know, promote things and think that he knows what's going on. He doesn't even play the damn game. So there we go. There's Brad. There's Brady. There's Static. I'm sick of the shit talkers. And again, at the Not on Blast show or whatever the hell that tag is, dude, just shut the fuck up. Seriously, that's it. And you use the word. You call people Nimrods? Like, really? Did you actually call someone a Nimrod? Like, no one talks like that anymore.
Isn't Nimrod like a character in a fighting game or some shit?
He's trying to blast me back here. Hold on. K-Frog, the skinny nerd. K-Frog, you are so bad. They had you doing interviews. Wait, hold on. Let me go up here. You're so bad they had you doing interviews in Canada. Ha, ha, ha. At least Tom is getting paid to do commentary. Does it feel good to interview guys from Canada? First of all, I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. Second of all, I'm blasting Brady for his attitude more than anything else. I mean, he talked so much shit. He talked so much shit when this game came out. It was unbelievable, and I have yet to see him back any of it up. Every time I see him at a tournament, he's always whining about how Sub-Zero got nerfed and how he's, you know, been, you know, this and that. Like, enough already, you know? Like, you talked the shit. You couldn't back it up. Like, whatever. Nimrod.
All right. Okay. All right. Someone.
Yeah, just, with that said.
Wait, not just somebody's speaker. Someone's speaker is on.
No. No, we're all good.
Yeah, we're all good. I don't hear that wrong.
I'm listening to the echo.
It's got to be your mic. I know, I'm a Nimrod.
Hello?
Yeah. Hello.
Okay, I'm there. All right, so.
I'm such a Nimrod, you know that? I'm fine. Right. I'm fine with being a Nimrod. I don't give a crap.
I want to express the on blast guy that's in the stream who said, you know, Triforce, you didn't do anything for Perfect Legend and so forth. If anyone noticed, this is the same song and dance with Justin Wong.
Yeah, guys, you got it. I don't even care about Mr. Caps as much as please write in English.
This stupid headset. I gotta get a new headset. All right, there we go. Sorry. This is for those who want to think. See, this is what I don't want. See how this guy thinks I'm sitting here blasting Carl. I'm not blasting Carl. You know. It's people are not understanding. No one's perfect. Just like how this guy's saying, you know, Tom Brady is this and whatever the case may be. Listen, guys, there's a difference between the personalities and the personas that people play in the community for entertainment and drama purposes versus someone who is just being them. And without putting anyone on blast, you will see later on who is who and what is what. You know, when Justin Wong left this organization was supposed to be dead. Remember that, James? Well, I don't know if you were watching from there. But we were supposed to be dead. Well, we don't have any champions. Now, the only person that was valuable in Empire Acadia was Justin Wong. Without Justin Wong, Empire Acadia isn't anything. Okay, then they went to Yipes. Then Yipes left. Oh, without Yipes, Empire Acadia is trash. You're going to die, blah, 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 blah. Then Yipes left. Then we had Dominion. Then Dominion left. Oh, well, without Dominion, Empire Acadia sucks, blah, 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 whatever the case may be. There's a pattern trending here. And just like those guys have gone, they've gone on to do things with themselves, and they're successful in their own right. This organization is still here. This organization is still winning. And we have won so much that I proudly boast. I proudly boast. And I boast this because I'm tired of people trashing us. But I boast that we are in the history books as the most winning competitive team in competitive gaming. So I don't care what you think about this organization or what you think about me personally, because you will always be talking about me. I will never talk about you. I don't know who you are. You're just a screen name in an On Blast show chat. So when you guys realize it, like, stop it, like the trolling, like, just cut it out. It's not going anywhere. It's the same old song and dance. I know you're looking for a voice, but you do not have a voice. You are just a number in a stream chat in which you're watching someone like MK James make the best of the community and give you guys some type of content to watch at 12:59 a.m. East Coast Standard Time. Like, just cut it out. That's just me dealing with the trolls. Now back to the situation. Your original question, what's next for Empire Acadia right now? Well, right now we're finalizing the deal on this. There's a movie, a documentary from this Wake Forest University, some guys trying to do called The Power Glove. Don't laugh at me, James. And pretty much they're trying to find out why The Power Glove was a commercial failure and what of its icon, reference, and cultural symbolism in today's time. They said when they Googled The Power Glove, I came up. So they want me to pretty much have a big role in that film.
Nice.
In about 3 more weeks, a Time Magazine documentary will be ready. And then I will be able to, I would like to debut the documentary on several streams. One of them would be yours. And like I said, we're going to be doing some stuff here with Nintendo based on the Wii U launch.
I want a Power Glove and I want a lefty. Make it happen.
They don't make lefties anymore.
Make it happen. I know you got some lefties sitting in a closet somewhere.
Actually, I don't. No? I really don't have any lefties whatsoever. this guy says, Nintendo and you are dead. That was the biggest troll I have heard for today. That should be the MVP troll of the day. The MVP troll of the day, real talk. But, yeah, so the next move for us is Injustice. That is going to be the game, and we're going to be working on that. I really hope Rio takes into that game hardcore. We're talking to Detroit Ballin. I have to see because Detroit Ballin, this is something, this is news, I guess you would like to know. Detroit Ballin was ready to leave Empire at MLG, but on a good note. It wasn't a negative thing. It wasn't like, you know, something was happening. He had a fallout with us. But Detroit Ballin has certain things in his personal life that are priority, like his job and his family. And we discussed that what he wanted to do, and he asked if he could take a leave from the Empire so that he can focus on that, because after MLG Rally, he wasn't sure what he was going to do with competitive gaming, period. So I completely understand that. See, stuff like that, that's what's the word for that? That's something that you have to take into consideration, because, you know, a lot of people got things to do with their life. So I have yet to talk to Detroit Ballin to find out what the situation is. Maxtress, obviously, VSM, EMP, and we still have Rio, and we still have Tom Brady. So Empire Gator still has a solid Mortal Kombat force and whatnot. But our main thing right now is to focus on Injustice, because these guys will be here. Number two, I'm getting a venue that seats 150 people. It's going to be in uptown Manhattan, where I want to host Mortal Kombat tournaments to help develop the MK scene. I want to also do a lot of the games that the Capcom community does not embrace. Because as you know, in New York, there really isn't any tournament viable venues that does anything outside of Marvel and Street Fighter. So I want to be able to help everybody who plays those other games, you know, like Mortal Kombat. Obviously, I want to push something for DOA. I also want to push something for Soul Calibur, Virtual Fighter, and so forth. As for this guy who asked, did we sign John Slayton? Yes, we did. John Slayton represents North Carolina. And Empire Kid is proud to represent someone from North Carolina. And I'm proud that we're getting another white player inside Empire Acadia, because it's just too many black
people. Yeah. Organization. It's the reverse bowling alley theory. The black bowling ball with 10 pins, the white pins. It's a white bowling ball with 10 black pins, man. Need some more of us crackers.
Yeah, well, you guys, now let's not use that word cracker, because I personally don't like that word. Like, here's something outside of gaming. Did you know on the Jeffersons, when the George Jefferson character used to, you know, call people cracker? I hated that, because I felt like, how black people complain about being called the N-word, yet they're calling white people crackers? Like, that's so stupid. That's like, okay, listen, you can't call me the N-word, but I'm going to come up with a racial slur for you.
I don't even understand. Hey, maybe you could shed some light on it. What the fuck is a cracker?
Literally what it means. Sometimes, like in the hood, a cracker, and it depends on what cracker you are. You can be a Jamaican water cracker. You can be a premium cracker, because the premium crackers are salted. So those are the angry white crackers that they refer to as angry white people.
So I guess if the On Blast Show guy had his way, I guess I would be a very salty cracker.
You'd be a premium, yes. And if you're just a regular white person, then you're a Jamaican water cracker, which is just a plain white cracker. It's so stupid.
Oh, man. The shit that people come up with.
Yes, the shit that people come up with. It's actually stupid. I actually hate it. I hate black racist jokes because it's not funny. It's like, I think white people only laugh at the jokes because in their mind they're like, okay, black man, get your jokes out, because I know you've been oppressed for so many years. So say what you got to say, get out of your system. Like, why can't you just go, hey, what was done back then was done back then. That's water on the bridge. It's not being done now. Move on. You see where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
So all those little comedians, that's why I don't like Chris Rock. People go, Chris Rock is funny. No, he's not. He's not funny. He uses way too many racist jokes. And I don't understand how a racist joke is funny. It's not funny. It's racist. It's not funny. I don't like when it... David Chappelle does not make racist jokes. David Chappelle, what's the word for this? David Chappelle has racist satire. And most of his racist jokes are making fun of black people for the most part.
So you can, like, when the slave master, when the slave master took the whip and was whipping them, and then they finally freed themselves and they whipping the slave master, you can get the, joke, not the joke in it. What's the word for this? Ah, damn, I'm bad with words today. You can get the metaphor in it. Kevin Hart's funny. Racial jokes, not racist jokes. Thank you for correcting me. But Cat Williams, yeah, I don't like those guys that make those jokes when they're being, oh, we got a couple of white people in our crowd today, and then everyone starts laughing like, what was that? That's, how's that funny? Like, I didn't see the joke in that. Like, what,
hey, I remember since you went to the Jeffersons, I remember there was an episode where Tom Willis actually called Mr. Jefferson a nigger on the show.
Oh, yes, and it was a big thing.
And it was a huge-ass thing, and I went, whoa.
But he can call him a cracker every episode, but he called him a nigger one time. It was I was like, this is so stupid. I was like, I hate this. This is why I don't like this. It's so dumb. Like, but everyone's like, no, Triforce, it's funny. I'm like, no, it's not. You're black, and it's not funny. What it is that you feel liberated watching a black man debase or deface a white man. That's why you find it funny. I'm like, that means you're racist.
Pretty much. Mexican comedians are the best. That's what Guido said.
Well, Mexican comedians are the best because Mexican comedians shit on every single person, including themselves.
Unless you're, what's his name? Mencia, who steals all his material. That was a whole big thing. I remember, like, I seen, like, a live thing one time where some other comedian actually went to one of his shows and confronted him in the middle of the show, like, saying, like, why are you stealing all my shit? And, like, he didn't know what to say. He was just like, well, this ain't part of the show, motherfucker. I'll see you outside. I was like, damn, comedians going rogue on each other.
Damn, that's crazy. Really?
And then where's his show now?
Wow.
That was one of the downfalls to his show.
Wow.
Here goes CD Jr. asking if you like fish sticks.
If I like fish. Junior, why do you keep saying the same joke to me all the time? Stop. I do not like fish sticks. I eat regular fish. Oh, man. Someone asked a question. Someone says, let me read this question to you, right? I don't understand how a person says they don't sponsor a player and still makes them money, attracts them to Empire. Explain. I'll try to explain this as best as possible. Empire Arcadia, unfortunately, in certain rights, is an organization that attracts undesirable players that have great potential. Because the video game competitive scene isn't developed to the level where there's a union, there's a commission, like an athletic commission or a cyber athletic commission, and there aren't development divisions where they can send a rep. Actually, wow, they're nearing it. Look at a player like Carlos Olivero. Carlos Olivero is considered to be like a scout, so to speak. His job was to go down into the gaming community and find people who wanted to help move the esports movement and help migrate or create a fighting game division or presence within the esports league. So he went down there, he met guys like Ataro and said, hey, listen, I'd like to introduce you to MLG and whatever. And then they hire Ataro, and then Ataro's job is to now recruit other people's blah, 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 and things of that nature. Empire Arcadia picks up the people that esports would find very difficult to manage.
Well, how come you didn't pick me up then? Because you know they think I'm the most difficult on the planet to manage.
The people who curse, the people who's not. No, that's not how it happened. I was just giving an example, Arturo. I didn't say that's how it happened. Carlos didn't get me hired. Okay. But Carlos, me and Carlos were hired independently of each other. Okay, can you explain it for us, Arturo? Which is
gonna, hey, Arturo, I can add you in.
Yeah, Arturo, would you come on and explain it, please, so that I don't what's the word for this?
I don't misquote
the wrong story. Yeah, I don't misquote the story. Well, pretty much what I'm trying to say is that is how the scene isn't to that. There's nothing to explain. We just got hired separately. Okay. And I showed up and he was there. But is it fair to say that they look to you to hire members from the scene to shoutcast that you felt would be good for MLG to commentate MLG's fighting scene? Is that fair to say? Of course. Okay, cool. So that's the point I'm trying to make, that we haven't really gotten there yet, but if when we look back in history later on after esports develops that scene, Artaro, what's this guy's name? Bibulous, Answer, Fubar Duck, Tom Brady, Juicebox. Yeah, those guys will be the pioneers that were selected to help foundate fighting games into the esports scene. Although, realistically speaking, it was actually Seb first. But I'm not going to go there. We're going to leave that alone. That was back when Tekken and whatnot was there. But, you know, it's something that people can look back on and say, oh, wow, these guys, you know, really, whatever the case may be. Now, esports wants to select people that they know they can work with professionally, that will represent them on a professional level and never deface them in public, which is obviously why they had a problem with you.
I don't understand.
But now, when you have teams like Diginauts or Dignitas, Navi, Mouse, EG, Complexity, yada, 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 those guys really don't want to get involved with the nigridom of the FGC as a whole. And for those who want to understand what nigridom means, go to any one of the local majors and watch how the community behaves in the crowd. MLG does not condone such nigridom, so to speak. It's just
In fact, I thought it was kind of funny when MLG Columbus, when Junior was playing PL, there was one brother in the crowd that displayed a perfect display of, as you say, nigridom.
Nigridom, yeah.
And I seen all the MLG camera guys turn the fuck away as quick as they could.
Of course. Actually, it happened at Rally when 16-bit first played against Perfect Legend. I was, man, the heckling I gave 16-bit. Holy smokes, that was crazy. I was going in the middle, right when they it was, I think the score was, well, Carl was up and they went to select the character again and pick her up was Soul Searching, and I was like, look at him, he's Soul Searching, hold that shit. But the guy looked at me and said, hey, you stop that. He cut me off, and I was like, oops, and I was done. You can't do that type of stuff there. There's a certain image, professional image, MLG is trying to lobby for, and for the people that they work for, the people that they do business for, and I understand their policies, and I completely agree with it. You could do that in the community, but you can't do that shit in MLG or any respected league. You can't do that. So those players, for the most part, have to find community-based grassroots esports teams. That's what Empire Arcadia, DMG, FYC at the time, and AG, and all those groups are. We're grassroots esports teams versus teams like EG and Complexity. Those are professional esports teams. So the undesirables in the community who can't make it to the pro scene come through us. Justin Wong actually said it when he left Empire on Live on 3. He says, I don't want to make Empire look bad. Empire is a great organization if you're starting out and you're trying to get into competitive gaming, esports. They're like the grassroots esports team. That's where you start. But if you want to take it a step further, you go to EG. Although, I don't like that statement, because I don't like it where it's like, if you want to take it a step further, because that kind of berates us. You know, we can take it a step further, just like EG. But you get the point of what he's trying to make. So to answer that guy's question, there's a whole bunch of middle fingers in the chat room right now. To answer that guy's question, that's where the undesirables or the people who cannot be developed professionally, they come to EMP, they get developed. I guess when they feel they're developed, then they leave and they go pro. So in a sense, Empire Acadia is like that, the D1 division. That's where you go before you get to the major leagues, so to speak.
I mean, hey, look, you know, unfortunately, by them doing that, mm-hmm. it narrows down the competition.
Yes,
I don't want to say it doesn't water it down. It weeds out, you know. And as a company, you know, I know everybody wants to get all fucking emotional about it and say MLG cares about us. No, they care about money. Well, it's a business. It's a business. Yes, and if I could put, you know, 100,000 people in seats as compared to putting 10,000 people in seats, why wouldn't I want to put the 100,000 in there?
All right. Hey, Junior, stop that. But okay. But all right. Listen to what you said. The reason why it's not fair to say it's about the money, the politically correct term is it's a business, because it is a business. At the end of the day, it's a business, and people have to respect the fact that it's a business. It is unfair to crack against the fact that it is what it is. People, like, I make certain practices or policies that certain leagues may have, I may not like it, but those are the policies in the leagues, and those are the policies that those leagues have, because they're representing their business. It's just like people don't like how I run Empire Acadia. I run Empire Acadia by certain policies. These are the policies this organization has, and some people don't like it, and that's fine. If you don't like it, I'm not going to change my organization because you don't like it. So MLG is not going to change your organization just because we don't like it. This is the nature of business.
I.e. the continuation rule. Perfect example.
The continuation. You don't like the continuation rule, you can go to another league, or you can go to a grassroots community circuit and play down there. That's just what it is. And someone says, Nintendo is dead. Your business is nothing more than a winning clan. Clans don't get joysticks sold. Clans don't appear in commercials. Clans don't have their own documentaries. Clans don't have their own trading cards. And clans do not get endorsement deals. That sounds like an actual business. So, yeah.
It sounds like it to me also.
Yeah. clans don't have money. Well, if we don't have money, then how can we make it to where we make it to? I don't understand this. Like, why do they say that? What you fail to realize is that, Junior, let's not talk about that. I have NDAs, so let's skip over that. All right, stop mentioning shit. Damn, yeah, Junior, you just be trying to get me some shit, man. Oh, boy. Anyway, so moving forward,
Here we go. Here's another nice comment for you.
Yeah. Okay. Your trifles. You're a cancer killing the FGC. What?
All right. You know what? I'm not banning you, but.
He deserves to get timed out because he's spamming
me. Yeah. Don't spam my room. You're timed out.
What's this guy doing?
Yeah. I'm not gonna. I didn't ban nobody. I just told him to sit down and think about being an asshole. You know, I mean, look, mm-hmm. the what is the end all solution to all of this? I don't know. I mean, I heard, like I was saying earlier, I think I heard ESPN actually talking about maybe looking to stream or to get involved with MLG now, which is, I believe, ABC owned.
Which is a conflict of interest to CBS.
Exactly.
Yes. Now fucking ESPN wants to get involved after SEPSA when Sundance told them to get down. Yeah.
Wait. You know what? CD Jr., I want you to type out right now in the chat that you like big cock in your ass.
What?
I want him to type that out. You want to be a mod, put out, you like big cock in your ass, and I'll make you a mod. Because I'm about to put you in a timeout, too. So if you want a mod that bad, tell everybody how much cock you like.
Oh, my goodness. You guys are so stupid.
All right. That's the deal. You want mod ship? There you go. Type away.
But the way this is going to work,
in terms of everything being fixed is very simple. MLG is bordering, whether we like them or not, this whatever our personal opinions to MLG is irrelevant. The fact is that they are about to open the gates for competitive gaming, professional competitive gaming, to go mainstream. Once that gate is open, all these people talking about I'm killing the fighting game scene, all this other nonsense that they're talking about, gamers are going to finally be met with a mature choice in life. Either cut the shit and become professional gamers, or stay in your community and rot. That's what it's coming down to. There is an $8 million League of Legends Season 3 tournament coming up next year. There was a $1 million Dota tournament that just finished a couple of days ago. Gaming is now at that level. People need to understand this. Maybe the fighting game scene is not at that level, but hey, look at the professional gamers who play RTS games versus the professional gamers who play fighting games. And you will see why we're getting $16,000 and they're getting $1 million. And it doesn't matter if you don't like it. Real talk, you can eat a dick. You either conform or die. Period. In a sense, I don't like it, but this is the nature of the industry, and this is where it's got to go. And if we want it to survive, we can support it. So Empire Arcadia supports it.
I mean, as much, and that sound, I mean, that is brutally honest, but do you not see it with the potential to self-implode at the same time? It doesn't matter about the money that's flowing. At the end of the day, if the followers aren't there, they're going to quickly quit.
I'm going to tell you why it will not implode. Because MLG gets it. The competitive gaming scene universally, only the leagues focus on getting their brand to the mainstream media, which is what matters. Why? A, it's new interests. B, it's entertainment. C, mainstream media has money. That's one hand. On the other hand, the competitive gaming community does not understand this. They believe that everything can survive through their community, and it cannot survive through their community. Why? It's too small. Number two, the community is broke. These motherfuckers ain't got no money. They don't.
How do you get to a tournament when you got to suck dick to get there?
80% of them are broke. They have to save their money to make it to any event. They don't have jobs. A portion of them go to school. Yeah, don't get me wrong and stuff like that. There's a good chunk of them that, you know, are financially, you know, semi-secured. But come on, like, realistically speaking, these people live in their father's basement. Stop. Like, yo, if MTV or someone said, let's go into the fighting game community and expose the truth, you'll have guys like Ataro talking about, hey, yeah, I'm glad I worked at MOT. Because he knows people will be put on blast. Seriously.
Just a short little commercial, guys. Fuck Dr. Pepper. It sucks ass. Drink Mountain Dew, bitch. Just a cross promotion there.
Someone says, I'll meet MTV at the door with my five pit bulls. Yo, it's like, this is, yo, I speak to some of the people that work at MLG who came from the fighting game community. And despite my past transgressions with them, whatever the reasons are, I'm actually happy for Ataro. Believe it or not. I'm actually happy for Ataro. I wish Spooky would just
stop, cut the shit, and go work for MLG or IPL and stop bullshitting in the scene, because there is nothing in the scene for them. Real talk.
Ed Fig, laugh your ass off. Imagine MTV's pro gamers' cribs. It would be hell from everybody's mom's and dad's houses.
Exactly, because they would be like, who are these people, James? Mom, you're embarrassing me. That's what you would get.
Mom, get me some Hot Pockets.
That's what you that's what you would get. That is exactly, and people can sit there and say, no, that's not what it is. Yes, it is. Stop. Stop. That's the truth. I never heard of Empire getting into MLG until MLG picked up MK.
Actually, oh, I can answer that.
Thank you.
You know, when I had my little squabble and I snuck around your website there, you've been involved, what was it, 2007?
We got involved in MLG in 2004. Then when MLG started to get their to synchronize their events with the fighting game community, when they had MLG Evo, we were there around then. Then Empire's first independent MLG event that we went to. Oh, actually, yes. The first independent MLG event we went to was in 2004 when they had Tekken. This was with Brian H. and Jin Master and Tom Brady and Red, and someone stole my power glove and all that other nonsense. But our first major MLG event at an actual center was in 2006 when it was at MLG Meadowlands when PC Chris beat Sephiroth Ken. So you don't know your in pass. Obviously, you are new. You are an 09er. You don't know about EMP. And we've been in MLG since that time. We've been in MLG 2007. We went to MLG 2010. Mewtwo King won 3 MLGs in a row for Empire Arcadia. Fighting GM was playing for Empire in Tekken. Then they took off, obviously, for 2011. Oh, actually, we had Legacy, Team Legacy, when they was playing Gears of War. Holy smokes, you didn't know about that, now did ya? Ha ha! But, you know, don't want to talk shit like they know. Listen, the Empire could be your father. You do not know what you're talking about. Please, whenever you're going to bring something up about Empire Arcadia, go to our website, go to our archives, and go into our library. Do your homework before you talk shit, because you don't know what you're talking about. All you know is what you heard from someone else's stream, and you're just running your mouth. I will say how I like Empire has guys playing Mario and other games. I said I was wrong, Triforce. I apologize. Wow, an upstanding individual who apologized for his error. Okay. Apology accepted.
Chris G, he just got into his house. He's setting up now, guys, so.
All right.
You know, but he just messaged me, so he's setting up. Him and Dre from Beefuteki.
Does Chris G even still play Mortal Kombat?
Yeah, he played at Summer Jam. He got DQ'd, but, you know, because he plays 65 different games at a tournament.
Somebody wants to know if my meat is 10 inches. I live at 970 St. Mark's in Brooklyn, New York. My apartment number is 1B. If you can please send your girl over, I will experiment with her, and she will let you know in private just how long my African mandingo is.
That was
a good answer.
Some of these people, why would you even? Why would you? And I hope that was a girl I asked that, because 9 times out of 10 it's guys I asked that, and that's so gay. Damn, why would a guy ask another man, how big is your meat? Hey, yo.
Remember, this is the fighting game community.
It could have been a guy.
It could have been a guy. Come on now.
Maybe he had a legitimate question and he was really asking.
It's 90% it's men. 90% of the guys ask other guys how big their meat is in the fighting game community. 90% of the guys.
I don't even know how big mine is. I haven't seen it in years.
Oh, man, this is good. My penis is 13.3 inches. Yo, you know what? All right, hold on. We got a problem.
Right, yeah, yo, Junior,
listen. Just because you from the islands, all right, don't try to use that island shit. Man, listen. You know Dominicans and Jamaicans be having mad beef when it comes to girls, because these dudes be, yo, they be rocking our shit. Y'all be stealing our shit. Y'all need to stop that shit, all right? Yo. Y'all need to really cut that shit out, okay? Anyway. I guess the next thing, I'm not going to be at MLG Dallas. I found out that what I'm going to be doing for Nintendo, I will not be able to make it to Dallas, unfortunately. But the team will be there. I sent in Rio's card to Twin Galaxies, to Walter Day. They got approved. So Rio is getting a video game trading card, everybody. Yay.
And oh, nice.
I'm working on Maxters and Detroit Ballin' next. So the community will have a collage of different...
I want a card, but unfortunately, my dick's so big, there's not a card big enough to put it on there, so...
You know, that sounds like something perfect.
You're going to have to put my picture's just going to be in a whole pack of cards. And you're connected with, like, the puzzle on the back that they used to have.
Well, all I have to say is I'm not going to sit here and boast about what inch my dick is. I'm just going to keep it honest with everybody. My dick is only 2 inches. From the ground. That was an old joke. Don't worry about it. And yes, it was corny. So, fuck
it's
it.
All right. It's all right. Okay. We've all gotten corny once or twice.
Yes, that was a classic one. That was a classic one. Anyway,
wanna blow my whistle, baby? Whistle, baby. What is CD Junior always like quoting songs?
What the hell?
I think he's singing that to KO. He's got a thing for KO Police.
One guy says, "Trifles, you forgot to let us know if you remember to masturbate with one leg up." You want to know about a dude masturbating and whether or not?
Wait. I got a question from a crazy Dominican Junior 02. Triforce, did you ever masturbate with the glove on?
You know, I personally think that is the number one asked question to me as a gamer. And that's sad because 99% of those questions come from men.
Yeah, pretty much. Wow, everybody wants to know about your sexual lifestyle now. Triforce, have you ever jerked off a white guy with the glove?
What the fuck?
Now, wait. Here's the thing I got to ask you. Now, with your glove, does it come with the... Do you have all these gloves with the white glove underneath still?
With the white glove underneath.
Remember it, when it originally came out, it came out with a white glove.
No. I don't even use the white silhouette to go to it. I put on these Nintendo wristbands so it can pad for my arm. I get rid of the white glove. But, oh boy, was that a fighting game?
No, I'm reading these questions, James. I thought this was the On Blast show. What is this? Hey, you know what? The faggot stream. Okay, as you call the On Blast show, you guys are dictating the questions right now. So I'm
and here. We are only talking about dick questions because you guys are bringing them up.
You know, I don't know about your juice. I know they're talking about grape juice and vodka, and I know CD Junior was talking about playing with his 13-millimeter dick. You know, but I mean, beyond that, I mean, I'm just going with the questions that are coming out here. Yeah, Mr. Molina is not here.
Oh shit! He said millimeter.
Wait, isn't that what he said? Oh, yeah, inches. Damn it, inches. Oh, I'm sorry. You dream about inches? I know you fantasize about having inches. Hey, Junior, did you ever suck a 13-inch fish stick?
This is
how
so
many
fucking...
legs do I have up when I masturbate?
What?
I don't have legs up. I don't masturbate. Yeah, I'll say that. I don't masturbate. I got a wife. She does it for me.
Why would you? And that's another thing. Listen. What is better, to be single, or to have a companion? Me personally, I can't understand why guys just like having girlfriends or being single. I can't stand it.
They have the pros and cons.
There is no pro in being single or just having some slide off better than having a wife. A wife, there's all pros. The only negative about having a wife is you guys get into arguments. But then the pro is you have the angry sex, you have the tired sex, you have all types of sex that just completely like destroys the con. So I don't understand. Like, that shit is crazy.
But you got to remember, sometimes being single is all about having the fresh meat.
What fresh meat? Okay, let me ask you a question. Fresh meat for what? What's the end result?
There ain't no end result. It's just the excitement of having fresh meat.
The excitement? So dudes want cheap thrills? That's what that is? You could go to a strip club for that.
Yeah, but you got to pay a lot more for that.
Yeah.
Okay, let's look at the economic aspect of this. Okay, so you meet a new girl, right? You have to take her out. Well, some guys are going to sit here and say, nah, what are you talking about, dog? I ain't paid nothing. Whatever. The fuck out of here. I hate when people talk about this shit. You spend money regardless. Cut it out. All right? You're going to spend money regardless. So if you're going to spend money and you have a wife, when you have a wife, she pays you at times. I'm like, you come home, honey, I cooked. Oh, good. You ain't got to cook. You can eat. Honey, I'm going to go take a shower. Oh, good. You get to take a shower with her. You get the bubblies on the titties and the ass. And, you know, you get to play around. You get to have ass on tap. So, honey, I just paid the rent and I'm kind of broke right now, but I need to go. She can hit you off. When you're having a stressful day, you get a pillow talk. You can watch a movie together and cuddle. You can play video games butt ass naked. Like, there's all these, like, pros. I can't understand, like, I just don't understand it. I don't. Like, why people are just so against, you know, companionship?
I'm not against the companionship. I mean, obviously, being married, but I like, you know, I mean, it has its pluses and it has its minuses. You know, a big negative is half your shit belongs to her.
Yeah, so what?
You know, well, if you're a greedy Gretchen like me, you don't want to share. I want the milk. I want the milk.
Yeah, I know. Thank God she's sleeping and she don't hear this.
I want the milk. I want everything in the refrigerator. What's yours is mine. What's mine is mine.
Actually, two comments I want to comment on. One guy says cohabitation is for monkeys. That's crazy. And then another guy says most are mere true niggers. Most are mere whores. What? Right. Disgusting. Huh? What do you mean by that, crazy Dominican? Oh, wait. Crazy Anaconda. Oh, damn. His name's all messed up. Lavender green, whatever the fuck that is. You can't read shit. But, Me personally, I just want one woman who's just into what I'm into and who will travel with me. And because the episodes I had when you, listen, James, when you have a girl and she's your bona fide woman and she's traveling with you, B, and y'all are good like that, like on some, that's like your boy, but she's your girl, yo, the sex is crazy. That's all I have to say. Try going to a video game tournament on a road trip in a plane and having sex on a bus in a plane, B. Best nut you'll ever have. That's all that's all I got to tell you.
Let me tell you, I brought my wife to some of the tournaments and she'd rather spend her time sitting online in a hotel room. And I said, well, what the fuck are you coming here? You can do that from home.
Yeah, but it's like, come on. If you have a regular girl, you got a gamer and shit and got to go through all this other shit, your girl... When you're with your bona fide woman, she's like, well, this is my man, and he's my bona fide man, and he's never going to leave me, and blah, blah, blah. You are committed to each other. So she can be a complete 100% filthy whore to you while you're having sex. You can have porn. You can have Brazzers, Spankwire, Pornhub sex, and it's... And she's not
going to... Shout-outs to XXXvideos.com.
And you're not going to have it where it's not going to be a situation where she feels, you know, you look at her in as like she's just a piece of meat. Because you're like, no, you know, you're just having casual sex and you're enjoying, you know, your sex and whatnot. That's the plus. To me, I've been single for like 4 years now, right? My friends are like, why are you single? Why don't you just like, just smack, hit and run? I'm like, how can you guys do that? I tried that once. Hit and run. I don't know how the fuck you guys do it. I cannot do that, B. That shit feels so disgusting and just... It's like you just met meat And then, like, get the fuck out of here. Like, what? Like she's a dog or some fucking animal found in the wild and some shit. Or there's a Serengeti of the fucking African Uganda jungle. Like, how do y'all motherfuckers do that? Like,
I got what's this? CD Junior asked me to put this video on from. Let's see what kind of trollness is real.
Oh god, not videos again. For the most
absurd fake reality shows we could think of.
He is going to fart, and you are going to guess what he had for lunch.
How far will people go in search of their 15 minutes of fame?
What the fuck is that?
What?
Who wants to be?
What is going on? What?
I'm gonna be a winner because I'm not a loser. I win everything I'm going for. I don't care. Throw a house on me. I'm gonna get it and I'm gonna win it.
This bitch looks like she's on crack.
Wow, hello.
Hi.
Mark Moore.
Ree Prudencia.
Moore on casting. Nice to meet you, Ree Prudencia. Welcome.
Thank you.
We loved your audition tape.
Oh, thank you.
You were so excited, and I'll do anything to be on a reality show.
I
love that.
I know. I need to do anything to be on a reality show. Everybody wants to see me.
So we've come up with the most bizarre talent competition.
Oh, she got me DSL.
We're looking at you to be on our first episode.
Yay! Yay! I'm excited.
But you gotta get through today.
I won't let you guys down.
Good.
You're not gonna suck.
What?
No,
yo, you saw that guy.
You don't suck.
I look like I suck? No.
Well, I hope you do suck because the name of our show is Just Suck It. So now, let me ask you again. Okay. Do you suck?
I'm gonna suck.
Yes!
We're looking for the most orally talented cocks? Girl on the planet. Not sexually. This is for regular TV. And we're going to test the abilities you have with your mouth in lots of different fun ways.
Okay.
What we want to do is just kind of warm up. Let's warm the mouth up. Just
warm it up on a horse cock.
Oh.
Like, see, I don't like this. This right here is objectifying. This is true objective. Like, come on. They're putting a measuring stick.
Have you ever heard that they golf balls from a garden hose?
What we have
is an industrial strength hose here. And a simple golf ball.
Okay.
So you're going to need you down on your knees.
I don't even find shit like that funny. Please do not get on your knees and try to.
Okay, when we put this in,
my God, she's
going to start the stopwatch. And we'll see how long it takes to suck this golf ball through the garden hose.
This is crazy, B.
Take it out of the hose with only your mouth.
Okay.
One, two, three, suck.
Suck!
Go, suck harder.
Oh!
Oh,
she's good.
Nicely done. That was amazing.
She'll only leave herpes on
your
dick.
Here's what we're going to do now. We are going to blindfold you. And then we are going to put various items into your mouth.
And you are going to try and identify like, what that is. This is why I'm thinking about just finding a woman from another country.
Can't bite it.
Actually, I don't even think you can find it from another country. I think this shit's all over the world.
There you go. Okay, here we go. This is an easy one. You ready?
Come on, man. That is OD. Come on.
Easy.
Yo, Junior, where did you find this shit, dude? This is crazy.
Go ahead and
see. And then look what type of sausage they got. Oh my God, stop it.
I'm gonna have to edit this video later on.
Okay, we're gonna accept hot dogs.
This is a big one.
Crazy.
Okay.
Dude. You know what? I feel bad about this situation. Because this could be someone's sister, someone's mother, someone's daughter.
A big one here.
But she got the fake titties going on. She like a stripper and escort, man.
This guy's putting a condom on a fucking soft. Oh my goodness. Don't tell me. Oh my God! This is.
What do you think that is?
This is wrong. This is wrong on all levels.
This is wrong on all levels.
I'm gonna reach out and try to get this girl on our show.
This is wrong on all levels.
That's it.
Oh boy.
And she's still taking
it. Salami. One last bonus round.
You know something?
5 points if you can get
if God came for us and judged us right now, I wouldn't.
They're putting a fucking toe hitch in her mouth.
Oh,
just put
my
your lips
goodness.
On it and feel
this
around because
just,
I don't want you to bust your teeth or anything.
That guy says that whore can suck a mean dick.
Now we want you to really suck on it.
Can you get around it?
There you go.
Watch your teeth.
What do you
this
think?
Is crazy.
Suck on it for a second. There you go.
You know.
There you go. It's getting a little warm.
Yeah. Any guys?
This is what you know the thing about this that's so fucked up?
No.
She should just go do porn.
No, that would be
what's the purpose of this? Just go
exactly.
Do porn.
Exactly. Just do porn. Make some money.
Yeah. I would respect her more
that's
if she just
hand.
Did porn. This is
she's exploring it.
This is actually far more. I'm mind fucked now.
Oh, God. Well, that was a CD Junior MK combo video.
Yeah, thank you, CD Junior. Now I have to edit that out later on. Jesus Christ!
You don't have to edit that out.
Yeah, on YouTube, I'm gonna have to edit it out.
Yeah, because it was a video. Actually, no, it wasn't a video from YouTube because you don't see the YouTube window.
No, you did when he closed off.
All right, then you have to take that out. And what we just said.
Yeah.
Oh, man. This is crazy, man. This is...
All right, I'm gonna make a call to Chris G because I want to know where the hell this guy is here.
Hopefully Twitch doesn't get at us for softcore porn on there just now.
That wasn't softcore porn. Well, I don't even know what the fuck that is. That was on any level. That was something else, B. That shit was something else. That was just crazy altogether.
I don't know where CD Junior finds this shit at, man. This fucking guy.
Yeah, that was degrading. That's exactly what that was. Guy says, "Is she blowing a trailer hitch?" Yes, she was blowing.
Yeah, it was.
She is finished. She's doing porn right now. She's doing porn right now. There's no way she can get a regular job. That's impossible.
No, there's no way. After that,
she's doing porn.
Yeah, I want. Can you work in my doctor's office as an admin, please? Please, that's never gonna happen. She just isolated herself from anything but sexual jobs.
That's it. She's got to be doing porn. And clearly, I need to know what porn she's doing because she looks like she's good at it.
I gotta say, she was pretty good at that. She got some nice fake titties too going on there.
Well, actually, that could be a Wonder Bra.
That's true. I wouldn't know about that. Junior knows about Wonder Bras. He wears them on Thursday nights.
Oh, shit.
Damn, that was crazy. That was crazy.
But I'm waiting for Chris G to get to me. I don't know where the hell. I know he was at 8 on the break last tonight. So he says he's almost home. Andre should be home in a second. So...
Andre.
Get these guys, Beefuteki.
Oh, okay. Junior, do not say that because people will take you seriously. They will copy what you just wrote and it will go around as you are actually wearing a thong.
What kind of thong are you wearing, CD Junior? Little Jack's American flag thong or
Oh my goodness.
Or a little Kung Lao thong?
It would be a Sonya thong, if anything.
We're supposed to be seeing that Sonya in Dallas, so I promise.
Actually, Junior, are you going to bring Sonya to Fight Club, Fight Arena?
I smoke 2 packs a day, Vandalus.
A male stripper thong with sex. You can't take this guy serious for shit. Oh, man. Are you gonna use Sonya at Fight Arena?
No, I think he made the promise to Carrie for Dallas that he was gonna use her.
Oh.
No way, we're gonna notify Carrie
if you don't use I'm gonna that's right, he can't go to Arena. Again you can't go?
How the hell cannot
go? No, it can't be again, man. Oh my god.
You're going camping? What the fuck? What the? Well, actually, it is the end of summer, so
it's his boys. He at the end of the summer, he always goes on his little boys' night out camping, and they snuggle up at the fire and tell ghost stories and spoon each other. That's how they roll. That's how the DR folk roll.
Oh man, next thing he's gonna tell me he's taking Rio with him, right?
Nah, Rio does manly things. Rio's gonna go build a car or something like that. Not, you know, he's gonna build a car or go to the rifle range.
Oh, it's a family camping. Oh, okay. Yo, James, you have any kids?
No.
You working on any?
No.
Damn, why not?
Why? Somebody else I gotta feed. Fuck, man.
James, you have a primal responsibility to the planet. You have a prime directive that's been put in your genes. You need to reproduce.
I'll reproduce. I just don't tell my wife.
Oh damn, that's just terrible, yo.
Damn.
Imagine she was behind him with the fucking frying pan and she just clocked him.
Dude, we have to make a gif out of that shit if his wife just clocked him with a frying pan. That'll be on every fucking thread and every fucking forum site out there.
Nah, my wife wants to. Oh wow, I adopted Bam now too. So I already got Detroit Ballins, one of my kids, and now I got Bam as a kid too now. So. And I think little Sonic is also a kid of mine now too.
Someone says, come on, Triforce, everybody cheats. It's in our DNA. Actually, no, it's not. We say that to justify why we want to. Everybody, I will say most, the generally most people want to cheat, but not everyone cheats and not everyone wants to cheat. It's a choice.
No, I don't have stepkids. I got no kids. No kids that I actually lay claim to.
Oh, shit.
I mean, I might have a couple of oopses and ran out the door. And I mean, I know I had a couple of oopses down in New Orleans. So I got maybe I have a couple of Cajun me's running around, but they haven't come knocking on my door yet, so.
You see what Factor just wrote? Triforce, do you think that's that there should be a celebrity Kong off? Word is some of the celebrities like Eminem play the game. First of all, that's not word. That's true.
Yeah.
That's true. Triforce, I'm sure you've cheated before. I'm going to plead the fifth on that one. All I know is this. I was faithful in my marriage. That's all I have to say.
Blowjob's not cheating.
Well, I'm not faithful there. I learned that on
The Mafia show. The Sopranos. Blowjobs aren't cheating.
Mm.
That's what they said, man. I believe them. And I learned it from Bill Clinton.
And I've been single since my divorce, so anything goes. And for the most part, sadly for me, you're James.
Yeah.
Here's a fun fact. I'm going to put my business out there a little bit. Guess how many girls I've had sex with in my 35 years?
Two girls and seven guys.
Damn.
One farm animal.
Oh, man, you guys are terrible.
Junior's saying four.
And Junior's close.
Six.
Yep.
Damn, I'm good. Call me motherfucking White Nostradamus. What was that? Black Nostradamus from Chappelle. You ever see that?
Oh, it predicted White Nostradamus?
Nostradamus was white.
Yeah, that is what I was about to say. What are you talking about?
No, Chappelle did a black Nostradamus. And he came out and he said, black America is finally going to get their own morning talk show. And it goes on at noon.
Oh, shit. That's fucked up. That's so fucked up. That's not even right.
I can't believe he left that show, man. I can't believe they fucked him like that, man. That was fucked up.
They were, you know what they were trying to do to him? They were trying to. Yeah, they were trying to do some shit to him. It was good to that he stepped away for his own sake. It shows that he has integrity in himself as a person.
Exactly.
So, you know, all the money in the world that they were offering him, he was like, "Nah, you're done. You are done." Have you ever? Nah, that's. Nah, I don't want to get into politics. I'll leave the politics alone, because I don't want to hear people's bullshit.
Yeah, politics. Let them talk in the chat. I don't get involved. I don't begrudge anybody's view, but just don't tell me my view's wrong.
Yeah, I'm gonna just leave the politics alone and whatnot. But hold on for 1 second. Let me do something real quick. Minimize your stupid thing. Let me pause your stream. Okay, good. Your stream is paused. Good. Because now I can play Bejeweled while we're talking.
Oh, man.
Don't laugh at me.
I play it.
There's nothing wrong with it. I played it too.
I play it. I play it on my phone all the time.
Oh, shit.
I used to play the Blitz one on Facebook. That was pretty good.
Oh, okay. That's godlike. But why is less than 10% of the world not rich? Actually, only 2% of the world is rich. 10% of the world is not rich because that's just the nature of the world. In order for the 2% to be rich, they have to pilfer the 98. That's just the way it works.
What is rich? Rich is more money than me, I'll tell you that. At that point, once you got more money than me, you're rich.
Yeah.
That must be a lot of Illuminati shit, man. It's all about the Illuminati. James plays video, old man. James play video, old man. Dude, I'll put one more of your knucklehead videos on. Let's see what you got now. Girl Swamp. Oh, God.
No.
Ugh.
No.
All right. So this is Junior. I mean, Junior, you know. Do you practice this at home?
Oh, you guys are silly.
Oh my god.
Now I'm eager to see what he's
yeah.
What the?
Oh my god.
I'm gonna go back to playing B Jewels.
Oh. Yes.
Some of this stuff is.
Yo, if somebody slapped him on the back and just shoved it all the way down, that'd be fucked up.
Oh, did that taste that?
This is just those type of things are not for me, really.
Yeah, I'm not my cup of tea. Yeah, this is more of CD Junior's style.
Hi, this is Tom from SuperGMatch.com. We're going to show you how to take a mad and swallow
here
it.
Here you go,
this
Junior.
This is one of the most dangerous tricks we
do.
Oh,
man, you guys are silly.
Ready, be careful. I'm going to take a balloon.
This is Junior on his practice mode.
Incidentally, Tom has tried to join the hot dog eating contests, but they've banned him.
And it's kind of funny because, like, you notice, like, he matched his balloon to his shirt.
Oh, he did.
Well, this is for Junior. I know. I familiar stranger. I like watching the girl went better too, but I figured Junior wanted to see this.
I'm trying to find out. I'm trying to find a dating service.
Dating service?
Yeah.
Lot of fish.
Isn't AOL chat room still around these days?
No, it's not.
Lot of fish. Go to lot of fish.
Lot of fish?
Yeah.
Isn't it called Plenty of Fish?
Or Plenty of Fish, that's it. Plenty of Fish, Lot of Fish, whatever.
There's a site called Plenty of Fish.
Yeah, it's just POF.
And girls go there.
Yeah, POF.
Wow.
I got a buddy of mine. He's been getting something from these girls for quite some time, but he keeps telling me, "Dude, you got to see this shit." You just chat if they don't like. If they like you, they talk. If not, you never hear nothing. And he says he cuts to the chase. It's like, what are you into? You want a little relationship? You just want to smash, or you just want to hang out? So you put down what you want. If they're into it, boom, you got it.
Some guy says, "Okay, Cupid." Now, I'm gonna tell you something about OKCupid right now. That site is ass, and that shit does not work. I've been on OKCupid since I was divorced. It's like 6 months after I got divorced, I was like, okay, I gotta start all over. And I'm not trying to admit it. I have no game. My game is ass. I'm dead serious. I have absolutely no game whatsoever.
Damn.
And it's like, that's because I always believe that honesty is just the best policy. Just say what you have to say. You know, there shouldn't be a reason to use game. I don't even understand the purpose of game. What is the purpose of it?
To woo them. To woo them.
Woo what?
To woo them, because if you don't give them enough game, then they just think you're lame. If you're just like, and we can go into a moment of real talk, guys. I keep saying this, there's no difference from us and those guys that wrap aluminum foil around themselves and go out into the forest and swing fucking wooden swords at each other pretending they're fucking knights at a round table. We're considered a cult, you know, of gamers, not, you know, so I mean, you know, it's kind of like, you know, I'm not going to mention this person's name, but when I was at Evo, they were explaining to me how they were getting all these girls basically wanting to move into with them, and I'm like, dude, they were strippers, you know, but no, they really liked me. I'm like, okay, there's strippers in Vegas.
No, it's not Tom Brady, I'll tell you that much.
No, it's not Tom Brady. It's not Tom Brady, you know, but these, you know, but these girls amazingly wanted to move to Ohio.
Oh God! You're so fucked up, James. Yo, real talk, you're fucked up, James.
And I just kind of sat there and said, "Damn, I didn't know I met the Black Pinocchio."
Oh, dude, you are so wrong, dude.
Oops! Yeah. I don't want to let out the name of that person, though.
Oh shit! Anyway, some guy says, I try to be confident, but it doesn't work. First of all, I don't try to be confident because, to be very honest with you, I don't give a shit. Like, I have that I don't care attitude, so whether the girl rejects me or not, I don't care. So that's just apathy. And sometimes apathy can go as, you know, false confidence. See what I'm saying? You know, well, the girl ain't going to know the difference, so who cares? So it's like, with that, what's... I don't know.
Look, I'll just give you my only piece of advice I can give you is if you hook up with a chick and she says she wants you to play a little bit, make sure you take the glove off first.
Boy. Am I gonna get that like for the rest of my life?
Nah.
It just sounds like I am though.
All right, guys, not for nothing, I'm going to have to, I don't believe I'm fucking, Chris G is going to make it. Fucking guy, man.
Yes.
I thought you said he was home.
He was, but I'm like, yo, what the fuck? I ain't getting no answer now.
What about from Beefu?
From Beefu? I'm going to call from Beefu right now. I'm going to ask him a question. Hold on.
Someone asked me, what does a glove smell like? That's crazy. What up, Junior? Which is the best handheld Zelda game? Link's Awakening. Actually, Junior, I'm looking. You know, my father told me, he said I need to find some guys around my age so they can teach me the ropes. I'm like, Dad, you make it sound like I'm pathetic. And he's like, you are, son. I'm like,
wow.
My dad's being an asshole to me. That's the problem. You see what he says? That's the problem. Everyone thinks when I say that, you know why I'm single? Because I'm not looking to get laid. If I want to get laid, I can just go buy it. I'm not that type of guy. I want something meaningful. I like companionship. You see how most guys are like, you know, they're into the, you know, just hit it and keep it moving. And they're not really into the, like, to knowing the person. I'm into that human connection with a woman. See what I'm saying? That's the type of person I am. I like laying in the bed and talking and pillow talking and cuddling. I like those type of things. Some people call that not manly, but if you fuck with me, I'll beat the living fucking shit out of you.
And I'll show dude, ain't nothing wrong with that.
I like hitting a girl from behind and putting my cigarette out on that rim of her back.
And so, guys, this Triforce thinks true loves exist. Yeah, I'm an idiot. I really do think true love exists. Rate myself in bed, 1 through 10, African.
What is this? He doesn't even pull over. He just drives away. Yeah, that's the way I do it, man. James likes hitting a girl from behind. He doesn't even pull over. He just hits it and drives away. Damn straight. You know, I'm...
She's there.
What's that?
He's in the room.
Oh, there he is. Jeez.
You have a wife that would laugh at me? Yeah, she probably have the right to laugh at me, though. Why don't I go to Jamaica and get a girl there? I was thinking about it.
Yeah, well, I mean, unfortunately, then you got to eventually probably bring them here, unless you plan on moving the empire to Jamaica.
That's not empire staying its ass in the Empire State. That's where the fuck empire is going. That shit is not going anywhere but America. No offense to the homeland, but not chill.
Nah, it's a great place to visit. You know, but living there is, you're going to be missing out on the game thing a lot. And opportunities. But it's a simpler life. You get to get drunk every day and lay down with your girl and have pillow talk. Because there ain't much of anything else you could do. If all white people died, what would you...
What would I talk about? You don't want to know what I would really talk about, because the type of conversations I have, people find boring. I talk about real shit with human beings. In fact, a lot of the things that I go on talk shows to talk about, I don't even want to get into it, because if I get into it, it's just going to be something else for you. You guys do not understand the shit that I'm into. The things I'm into, like science. I'm into like one with the earth on some Gaia shit. You know, that's the type of stuff I'm into. Fractional banking. What? 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 What?
This guy is one of... He's almost up there with Monkey Chime as far as the trolling.
What the fuck? What the fuck? Fractional banking? What the fuck?
Triforce, your personality doesn't match the way I thought you'd be at all.
Nah, because first of all, I will say this, and this much I know is a fact. I am the most misunderstood person in the fighting game community. No one knows who I really am. They don't. They can say they do, but they don't. I know that for a fact. They do not. People do not know who I am.
All right, Chris, add me on the, it's just James MK on Skype, so add me in there instead of chatting away. You know, but, yeah,
Ricky Williams, hold on, he left stuff to live his life how he wants, to be one with the earth. Actually, I'm going to give you guys an ideal of the type of person I am. Do you know about, what's that guy, he just killed himself 2 weeks ago? He was like some mogul, some hip-hop mogul or some shit. Oh, my goodness. He killed himself because his wife left him. His wife divorced him. The guy's a millionaire and a billions. Come on, guys. One of you guys on the stream knows. I forgot his name. And no, it wasn't on TV. It was on news. The guy said he doesn't watch TV. Don't you pick up a newspaper at least? Damn, what is his name? Everyone, no, it's not Damon Dash. Someone like him, though. Chris Lighty. There we go. Chris Lighty. Chris Lighty killed himself. Oh, thanks, Beef for Techie.
We got Beef for Techie in the stream now, too. Yeah.
Chris Lighty killed himself because he could not see himself no longer with his wife because she left him. That's the type of person I am. All of this shit we do in this world doesn't mean jack shit at the end of the day. At the end of the day, the only thing that matters is the love of your family and being one with your fellow man. All right, they even teach you this back in the 80s. Anyone remember watching Conan the Barbarian? Hello?
Yeah, we're here.
Oh, my fault. Do you remember watching Conan the Barbarian?
Yeah.
James, you all right?
Yeah, no, I'm trying to add Chris G.
Oh, you're trying? Oh, okay, yeah, okay.
Okay, got
so,
it.
So, in Conan the Barbarian, remember when he robbed, when Conan, the girl, the and that Asian thief robbed the king for his ruby?
Yeah.
Big ass ruby and shit like that? Oops, didn't mean to do that. Okay, so when he robbed them for that ruby, right? The king brought them in. I thought they were, everyone thinks they're going to be executed. And the king says, what did the king say to them again? King said some shit like, you like the jewelry? And they were like, kind of like, they were like, yeah, yeah, and whatnot. And then they, the king threw the gold at him and says, I want you to do me a favor. So Conan's like, why should we do you a favor? Like, what's in it for us? And the king gave him more rubies, and he's like, bring out all the gold. And they gave him all the gold. And he's like, why are you giving us all this gold when we just robbed from you? And the king said to him, when all the luster from the gold vanishes and all the sparkle from the gems disappear, all there is that's left in a man is the love of the father and the love of a husband. If people ever understood what that is, then they'd know what it is to truly be a man. Because everything else in the fucking world is complete bullshit. Now, that was an 80s movie.
I don't remember the 80s. I'm sorry. I was in the 90s. All right. Do I got Mr. Chris G here?
Hello, buddy.
My God. What the hell happened to you, man? What were you going into, like, double, triple overtime out there in Jersey?
Nah, man, it don't end till late, you know?
Man, I was like, man, I had this guy on at 1 o'clock. Here it is 2 o'clock, and I'm the one that's supposed to always be late. So how'd you do tonight?
I won.
In?
Marvel.
Marvel? Who'd you use?
Random team.
Wow, see that guy's
wow,
random.
Wow, really, a random team?
He just goes random on you guys. So, yesterday we talked a little bit about the local battles thing and all that. I'm not going to rehash on it because I know Beef Uteki, who was looking to talk to Phil, they actually wound up talking today. Is the world a glorious place as of now? I doubt it. It is what it is. Guys got their own agendas. Guys are doing their own thing. And hopefully, you know, people won't be stepping on each other's feet no more. Wow, look at that. Chris G was laying some Latina pipe. Why would he have a Latina pipe? Would it be Latino? Not that I speak proper Spanish, but I would think the O should be there. You know, I mean, that whole drama that was basically going about, you know, and I said this earlier on my show. I spoke to Phil today. Everything seems to be, I guess, a calm now. I don't want to say everything's perfect, but, you know, we'll see how the next couple of weeks go. But as far as you, what's next for you as far as tournament-wise?
I'm not sure. I'll be at Season's Beatings. So that's pretty good.
Now, Season's Beatings, what do they have? East Coast or is it New York versus the World or whatever what do they got going on over there? For Marvel?
Like what?
I don't know, I think I saw something East Coast or US versus
East Coast
the World.
Yeah, East Coast versus West Coast, and I think they got the World versus something, I don't know. They come up with whatever they want to name it.
All right, let's see what I got here. Let me add, George, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
See if you get some questions for him. I'm going to add Beef Uteki quick.
Oh, shit. I didn't put anything out. Nobody's posted a question.
Oh, well, anybody got questions, ask them straight in there while I add Beef Uteki to this.
I'll ask Chris G some questions.
Go for it.
All right. Chris, This time around, the last time East Coast versed against West Coast, because I haven't been around to know about the whole Marvel scene. Who won the match? Who won?
West Coast.
West Coast? All right. Going into season's beatings, do you think that East Coast is ready?
Yeah, I think East Coast is ready. For the most part.
Who's on the team?
I have no idea.
What? Y'all going in there just raw, blind, just like that?
That's usually how it goes.
Oh, shit. What the fuck? Oh, my God. Oh, well. So, who would you like to be on the team? Who would your five-man squad be? Obviously, you're on it. So, who would your five-man squad be for the East Coast?
If I could, I'd pick all five Fublats.
Fublat? Who else?
Four more.